Duke University opened the 1992 season against nationally recognized Plymouth State College of New Hampshire as running back Tony Mazzatesta breaks a 62-yard draw play to put the football on Plymouth State's 16-yard line. Wilkes controls the line of scrimmage against Plymouth State as all-conference running back Jason Smith sets up the go-ahead touchdown with his 30-yard run, assisted by Larry Udisky's big block. The offensive line continues to dominate as Smith breaks the 20-yard dive play to secure an opening game victory, as well as a key third-down play to help the Colonels with their first MAC victory against Albright. In the third game of the season, Wilkes moved the football against nationally ranked Susquehanna University as the offensive line and Jason Smith dominated the inside running game. Jason Smith continues to show why he is an all-conference running back with this great individual effort against Moravian. In the fifth game of the year, and with defenses keying on every play, Jason Smith, the offensive line, led by Jason Langdon's trap block, sprung Smith for a 65-yard touchdown run. Tony Mazzatesta shows his versatility by returning this punt 65 yards against Lebanon Valley. Fullback Larry Udisky of Wyoming area, known for his blocking ability, breaks this dive play for 39 yards against Delaware Valley. Jason Smith follows the blocks of fullback Larry Udisky and tackle Keith Fox for the game-winning touchdown against Delaware Valley. On the turf at the Lackawanna County Multipurpose Stadium, Wilkes continues its punishing ground attack with the inside running game by Jason Smith and the outside running attack by Carmen Zulo. Playing with his right hand in a cast, Jason Smith went over the 100-yard mark for the sixth consecutive conference game with this play against Widener. In the season finale against Lycoming, Jason Smith established a single-season record for rushing attempts, 241, and rushing yardage, 993 yards on this draw play. Wilkes showed its offensive diversity early in the 1992 season as quarterback Boo Perry of Canton, Pennsylvania, completes this touchdown pass to Dan McClave against Plymouth State. Perry continues the airborne assault by hitting all-conference receiver Steve Andrews with a 62-yard touchdown pass. The Wilkes passing offense worked as a team, evidenced by this tip pass completion against Albright. The offensive line continues to give quarterback Boo Perry time to complete a key sideline pass against Albright. Wide receiver Steve Andrews continues to display his all-conference ability by catching this third down pass to keep a drive going against the Crusaders of Susquehanna. The Colonels locked in a tie with nationally ranked Susquehanna drew first blood on this exceptional touchdown catch by tight end Gene Consellier. The Wilkes passing game continues to provide momentum as Chris Zellner goes high in the air to make a catch against Moravian. Quarterback Boo Perry hooks up with Steve Andrews on this catch as Wilkes begins a late game comeback against Lebanon Valley. The comeback against Lebanon Valley continues as senior wide receiver Dan McClave makes a 100 catch on a football thrown perfectly by quarterback Jack Sweetheart. Defenses were not able to key on one receiver as witnessed by this Dave Wisolowski catch of a Boo Perry pass against Delaware Valley. The aerial attack continues with the offensive line providing enough time for these key receptions against Delaware Valley. The teamwork continues as Dan McClave works in tandem with Chris Hignon for a big play against Uppsala. A punishing ground attack set up this 40-yard play-action touchdown pass from Perry to Endress. The Perry to Endress combination continues with this 60-yard reception at Widener. Tight end Gene Consiglio shows his versatility on this perfectly executed play-action pass against Widener. With two games left, wide receiver Dan McClave takes over the quarterbacking role and finds Mike Hawkins with the go-ahead touchdown against Juniata and also hooks off with Steve Endress against Lycoming. A big hit by Mike Modla against Plymouth State of New Hampshire sets the tone for the 1992 season. Mark Buss of Dallas continues the defensive domination as he crunches a Plymouth State running back, followed by a big defensive play against Albright in an opening season win in the MAC. Freshman Aaron Wilk fits nicely into the defensive scheme as evidenced by this upending tackle. Linebacker Bob Brish exhibits the Colonel's physical style of football play on this tackle against conference foe Albright. Chris Carr and Mark Buss, along with the entire deep ends, kept the pressure on the Albright quarterback the entire football game. Susquehanna, which led the league in rushing, found the going very tough as Mark Buss makes one of the biggest hits of the 1992 season and follows up with a key sack to take the Crusaders out of field goal range. Aaron Wilk of Shamokin made his presence felt early with the sack, which caused a fumble against Susquehanna and a big hit against the Moravian wide receiver. Bob Brish continues his outstanding play from his inside linebacking position with the perfect play against Lebanon Valley. The Colonel defense, led by Larry Trakes and Joe Woodward, prevented the Lebanon Valley offense from getting on track. Bob Delbo continued to keep the pace of the Wilkes defense with a crunching blindside sack of the Widener quarterback. Mike Modla sets the tone early in the Juniata football game, and the defense responds with the big play after the big play. Modla caps off this defensive effort with the hit of the year on a Juniata wide receiver. The aggressive style of play continues as Bob Delbo and Larry Trigg swarm the Lycoming quarterback. Mike Modla continues his patrol of the middle of the football field and makes a big impression on the Lycoming wide receiver. Co-captain Mike McCree makes his presence felt at a key third and one play against Lycoming. Wilkes' defense was very opportunistic in taking the football away as Mike Modla intercepts against Plymouth State, and Mike McCree causes a key fumble against the Greyhounds of Moravian. Also against Moravian, the defense rose to the occasion in stopping the Hounds on a key fourth down play. All-conference quarterback Ben McEwen made his presence felt with an important interception against Lebanon Valley. Carr continued pressure on the opposing quarterbacks as shown here, causing a fumble against Lebanon Valley. The special teams also shine this year as Mark Davies blocks a Delaware Valley punt to set up Wilkes' first score of the football game. Harry Trakes, the conference leader at sacks, is shown here running down the quarterback from Delaware Valley as well as the following week against Uppsala. The Colonel pass defense played its most opportunistic game against Uppsala, with three second-half interceptions, including Ben McEwen's, Joe Woodward's deflection to Aaron Wilk, and the game-saving interception by Gene Silvers. McEwen again proved to be in the right place at the right time by scooping up a fumble caused by Larry Trakes and also hauling in an opposing quarterback's pass and heading upfield. When the Wolves' defense was needed most, it stepped up by causing a fumble against Juniata, as well as the game-winning interception returned by Aaron Wilk. Ben McEwen secures the victory with a very late interception, snuffing out all hopes of a Juniata comeback. Wilkes University ended the 1992 season as it started by swarming to the football, playing great team defense, and giving an all-out effort as typified against the Lycoming Warriors. Looking back at the 1992 Colonel campaign, the Colonels unquestionably came together as a football team. Many questions were answered early when a genuine excitement engulfed the program of Wilkes University. The excitement of the football program being on the rise was evident all throughout the season. With Wilkes becoming a dominant force within the conference, each week became more thrilling as the Colonels continued to strive to meet the challenges that the Middle Atlantic Conference presented. Whether it was offense, defense, or special teams, the 92 season instilled a sense of pride and unity that will be the basis of an ever-optimistic future. The excitement of the first winning season since 1987 and the commitment of all those associated with the Wilkes University football program can only enhance the attitude and desire of a team that's main focus is to lead the program to a brand new level. We'll be right back.